God, I'm Mark Winne. Thank you for coming, and thank you, Food and Water Watch, for taking the lead on this very important initiative. Thank you, Senator Wirth, for sponsoring this. You must have been anticipating a very boring session, so maybe you had to take on something a little more controversial. You're a courageous man. Everything that's been said is right and good. I'm probably going to I don't want to repeat too much. I want to try to underscore some of the important things that have been said. But I do think that SB 18 does two really important things. The first is that this is a bill that's good for consumers, it's good for food processors, and it's good for farmers. And the second is that the industry opposition to this bill, which I'm sure will be out there, and it's similar to opposition in other states around the country that are trying to do the same thing as New Mexico, is a threat to our democracy. It is undermining our ability as citizens and consumers to make choices. On the first point, I want to note that consumers, it's already been said, but I don't know why we can't just accept this fact, but consumers do have the right to know. I think if we look at every gain in our nutrition standards and in information throughout, since, say, World War II, we as citizens and consumers have had to fight for labels on cigarette packages, we've had to fight for labels on alcohol containers, and we've had to fight for information about nutrient ingredients on food packaging, how much sugar, how much fat, what's there. The industry doesn't do that voluntarily. We have to fight for it. And I think the industry, if you had a comparison to make, it would be like saying that the way that mushrooms are raised, the industry wants to keep us in the dark and feed us manure. Information is power. And if we have that power, we can make the right choice for ourselves. But without that information, we're just flailing about in the dark. And as far as GMOs go, we don't yet have the facts. The science is not in. The industry might say it's safe, don't worry, it's okay, trust us. We've heard that before, and it hasn't proven to be true. So until all these risks are fully resolved, the consumer should be able to make their own choice. We must, if there is doubt, err on the side of caution. And this bill is also, as I said, good for farmers, and it's good for processors. It's almost like the Organic Standards Act that was created about over 20 years ago by the U.S. Congress that puts an organic label on our food. When they did that, we saw a huge industry grow around organic food. Today, the organic food business is about $30 billion a year, and it's the fastest growing industry segment, food retail industry segment in this country. The same, I think, will happen for GMO, non-GMO products. The second point about the passage of Senate Bill 18 is that it will be a victory for democracy if we're able to pass that bill. Just as it's good for consumers and farmers, it'll probably be less so for those who make a lot of money from GMO products. Now, I want to give you one illustration. I have a little prop that I carry around with me. It's actually a little tube of chapstick. That's all it is. No big deal, right? Except on the tube it says Monsanto. Now, this is not genetically engineered chapstick, so don't worry. But however, it was in this bag, this knapsack, backpack, that was given to every chairperson of state legislative agriculture committees in the country who came to a conference in Arizona in January of 2011. And they were brought together, and their trips were paid for by Monsanto, Syngenta, Archer Daniel Midlands, kind of a who's who of the agricultural industry. Their spouses came with them, all paid for. I don't think Senator Wirth was invited. Or maybe he just doesn't like spas. I'm not sure which it is. But the very, very powerful people at the state level, all states, were brought together for 3 days of propaganda and pummeling and misinformation by the industry. In other words, the industry had unprecedented access to our most influential decision makers at the state level. Not only did it have chapstick, it had all kinds of other little tchotchkes and mementos, including this propaganda information from Monsanto. You're welcome to look at it later, with all kinds of hopeful guides about corn, soybeans, cotton, etc. This is how the industry works. This is how it gains access. Thank you. It has killed anti-GMO bills in legislatures across the country. In Montana, they took the legislators into a private club and were able to convince them to kill a bill that had the vast support of residents in Montana. They did the same thing in Hawaii. Last year, they threatened to sue the states of Connecticut and Vermont if their legislatures passed GMO labeling legislation. Those two states were forced to withdraw those bills, even though they were likely to pass in those cases. And of course, you've heard about Proposition 37 in California, where the LA Times said in September, 60% of the residents favored the passage of Prop 37 that would label products containing GMOs. After spending $45 million, the industry was able to reduce that number down to 47% on election day. The list goes on of how industry purchases our democracy. It's not just food, it's not just GMOs, it's everything, not everything, but it's an awful big segment of our life. Can be everything. We have to fight back against that. You know, the only choice we have is to fight back, to be citizens and to have our voices heard. And we can't let industry continue to purchase our democracy, and maybe New Mexico can be the first state in the country that puts the will of the people ahead of the power of the wallet. So please support SB18. Thank you.